very important concert for our music department. It is in support of our endowment music scholarships, which helps many of our students that are studying instrumental music or vocal music. They might be taking private lessons. Many of them join in ensembles. And these scholarships fund them for basically preparing them for their future in music. We've had so many students be able to partake in the scholarship, and it has made a big difference in their lives. Many alumni who has gone on to major in music have started with this endowment music scholarship. Also, we've had many students who went on to do amazing things in many areas, but their education in music has helped them along the way and instilled a love and appreciation for music and what it does for your brain in education. This scholarship has been running for quite a long time. It was started by Vern Freiberger, who helped set up the endowment that runs through our foundation office. And it's just quite an advantage for our college and especially for our students. New tickets, the sales help fund it, but also any donations that we give tonight will help immensely. So please, you may have seen some baskets out there. If you are able, please give some donations, and that too will go to this worthy fund. Now, there's a few housekeeping guidelines for our performances. If you've been to some, you've heard this talk before. This is our last concert, but still, the audience etiquette is an important piece to a successful concert. So please silence your cell phones, and in fact, turn them off, and that'll keep you from being distracted from what you're about to hear and see tonight. Also, please refrain from flash photography. The flash kind of, sometimes it startles or stuns our performers, and you don't want to do that. We are filming the concert. We have a professional videographer, and thank you very much for doing that, who will post this concert on YouTube, so you will be able to see it there. And if you have children with you, I think it's wonderful to start having your youngest family members engage in the arts and enjoy music, excellent music. It makes a big difference. It did in my life, and I'm sure it would in theirs. However, if they start getting antsy and having a hard time sitting and wanting to make noise, please take a moment to think of them and the fellow audience members and take them out into the lobby area. Have a walk around. We have a screen playing the concert so you can see and hear what's going on. Let them be a child and let them enjoy the evening instead of having them feel like they have to sit and be quiet. And then when they're ready, bring them back in. And believe me, they'll appreciate it and feel like this concert was a wonderful experience. So please do those things. Now, we have so many performers that you will see tonight. In your program, you'll notice that we start with the instrumental music portion. Then we have singers coming, the Hilltop Singers, our different music groups that are da capo and dolce, and then concert choir. And then we end again with our instrumental, our jazz band will play. But in between the instrumental and the vocal, we will have a very special speaker, Lindsay, from the foundation, will come and talk to you as well. I would like to thank Lindsay for being here tonight and the foundation for all their work that they do with us. I would also like to thank our administration, our Dr. Heilman, our president, is very supportive, and Vice President Elaine Simmons, thank you very much for supporting the arts this full year of attending concerts and watching what our wonderful fine and performing arts team is doing. Thank you, Dean Brian Howe, for all you do to support us and keeping us together. I know it's a task, but we really appreciate your work. Thank you, Mark Dean, for leading our facilities, and also Dean Angie Maddie for being our Vice President of Student Services and helping with our fine performing arts students. We have so many thank yous, so please take a look in the program for those thank yous. Now, last, I would like to invite out our performing arts instructors. Are you back there? I heard I was supposed to call you out. And here they come. So I would love to introduce our team, who I would like to say it has been a dream to work with this year. I've loved working with Jamie Vinneman, Dr. Alejandro Avila, and Dr. Eric Foley. So please give these I hear many comments from their students frequently who come out of rehearsals, who come out of their lessons, who talk about what they are learning and feeling very, they feel challenged in a very positive way. So they're like, ooh, they worked me hard this time. And they, but they also respect each of these teachers for what they are giving them and all that they have done for them this year. So please give them one more round of applause for these teachers. Thank you again for being here, and I hope you enjoy the concert. a little bit about a dance that goes along with the next piece, All in the Garden Green. This piece was codified or documented in 1651. It is an English country dance. It's a couple dance that would be classified as like a courtship dance. So it's typically done with males and females in lines with each other. It, even though it was written down in a manuscript called The Dancing Master, it's actually an older dance. The piece of music is definitely older than 1651. And at this time period, dance and music went literally hand in hand. I know that's a terrible pun, but they were created to be done together. And so we have a little example of that tonight. So this dance would have been around the time, maybe when Romeo and Juliet would take place. Could be done in a court that would be where nobles would be dancing. At that time, you would show your best fashion. A lot of times, dances were a time that you would wear certain clothes that would wow, the hosts of the court. But many of these dances also, many of the court dances started with folk dances and folk music, and then refined to become court dances and more refined court music. So this dance would have at least two people. So I have a couple to come out. Can I have Ashton Ramsey and Robbie Ross come out, please? And they will demonstrate the steps. So Ashton Ramsey, you want to hear Ashton sing later? This is not what he would be wearing in the court. But what Robbie Ross here is wearing is something similar that you might find, probably more layers. This might be more the folk version without all the petticoats. However, it would be very similar to the style. Now, they will demonstrate the steps, which are very simple. So this is without music. So could you please face each other? So first, this is the dance that's in 4-4. So everything's grouped in four beats or four counts. And they would start stepping with their left foot walking towards each other and left shoulders going towards each other. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 is when they go back in place. Now, they would not normally touch shoulders. They'll keep a buffer with their shoulders. So going right foot and right shoulders. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, good, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was well done. So now we'll go back to the left shoulder. So the set goes, walking left foot, 1, 2, 3, 4, going back, 5, 6, 7, 8. They step to the right on each side and touch, step to the left and touch, and turn to the right in place, 6, 7, 8. Now we go for the right shoulders. Ready? And 1, 2, 3, 4, walking back, 5, 6, 7, 8, step to the right. 1, 2, touch, steps, 3, 4, and turn, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now normally this dance is not done with only two people. Normally you have a line of people, at least 6 people. So we're going to have to get more people soon. So the man on the left side, on the right side, I'm sorry, will walk and shake the lady's hand across from him. Yes, this is part of the dance. So Ashton will walk and pretend he's shaking a lady's hand, then another lady's hand, then the third lady, he shakes her hand, and now they normally would kiss. We're not kissing tonight. Side, take both hands and turn 360 around, one, two, three, four, five, six, stepping back, seven, eight. Now, in the music, we have a break right there, and there is a bell, which is in our version of the music. Then they go back to stepping left foot with left shoulder, one, two, three, four. Now I'm going to speed it up, going back, five, six, seven, eight, step right, touch, step left, touch, and turn around. And then right shoulder, one, two, three, four, stepping back, five, six, seven, eight, step right, touch, step left, touch, and turn around to the right. Now the lady gets to come and shake hands. So the lady on the right will shake hands. And the third man is Ashton. And shake his hand and lean side to side, both hands, and you turn around 360, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then the man gets one more chance to shake hands. And he comes across, and this time we would do the man on the left, shaking hands and turning, and they would bow. This could go on for multiple repeats during the dance if we were in a court or at a festival, but we're only going to do that much. Now, I need more people. So, I have one more volunteer backstage. Bryce, will you come on out, please? Thank you. I need one male and two females who are willing to get up here and dance. And I'll talk through it. I see Joe with a camera walking around. I was like, there's one, someone who's coming up. Anyone? No, I see people hiding. How about you two? You perform? No? Anybody? No? Wait, is Sayaka in the audience? Hey, Sayaka, come on down. Okay, we got someone. All right. Oh, my God, yes, very good. We need one more lady. Karen? She's coming? Dr. Avalesa, she's coming. Very good, yes. Oh, yeah, please, yes. Didn't you hear the message that we sent out? All right, thank you. All right, so thank you very much for coming on up. Please give them a round of applause. Part. Everyone else, please be dancing in your heads, because if you ever end up, you know, at a place where they're doing English country dances, you will be prepared. This is a skill that you may need in your life. You can put it on a resume. So, okay, so first you're going to step with your left foot towards each other, moving left shoulders towards each other, but you don't want your shoulders to touch. All right, so ready? Shake hands to the first lady and go. Now you're going to shake hands with this lovely lady and lean in side to side and then turn to her. To dance like experts.
I just want to thank Danica again for that. That was really fun. And thank you, volunteers, for coming up and being great. We're going to close the orchestra portion of the concert with a medley. And I'm told it's not Leroy Anderson, it's Leroy. So you now know how to pronounce his name correctly, right? And he wrote lots of compositions for the Boston Pops Orchestra, lots of number one hits. The ones that you're going to hear tonight that hopefully you'll recognize, The Syncopated Clock, Blue Tango, Plink Play Plunk, and Serenata. So thank you again for coming, and we hope you've enjoyed the orchestra.
Thank you. And I am the executive director of the Barton Community College Foundation. For years, the endowment concert has added funds into our vocal and instrumental music endowment, which is a very unique fund within the foundation. And it's a perfect example of how small things can add up to have a huge impact. So I'm going to keep it short and sweet because you have better things to listen to than me. And I have two notes of thanks that I wanted to share with you. The first one is from a student named Jeremy. Thank you for the scholarship. It means the world to me to know someone cares about my future. This scholarship will help with funding for books and instruments, and I am extremely thankful. Thank you. The second one is even more about our music program and our scholarship program. To the Barton Foundation, I am ecstatic to hear this news as it makes the finances for the remainder of this year as well as the next year significantly easier on me and my family. My most sincere and extensive thanks go to the foundation as well as the generous donors, that's you guys, that make this possible. The experiences I have gone through for this fall semester involving the music program have been incredible and unmatchable. Between the people I have met and the skills I have learned, nothing can compare. I learned music very casually for many years, and now I have a band with which to play and an instructor to help push my music skills, which is truly indescribable. Initially, I was willing to make the financials involved with taking all the music courses work somehow, simply because of what they meant to me. But because of this scholarship, I can take these courses without worry. The donors of these funds have done me and my family an incredible service. Thank you for everything you have done in my life. And I think this goes to show that the ticket price that you paid and any donations that you do make later go to make a huge impact in not only one student, but numerous students every year receive this scholarship. And I want to thank each and every one of you for attending, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the concert.
This is a little different for us. Hilltop has generally been a show choir, and so we're trying something a little bit different. We're single mic'd. Everybody's on a mic. And that kind of comes back to what we're doing as far as the literature for this. We're actually doing two tunes that are really vocal jazz arrangements. And both of those are by a great Ben native. He's arranged both of these, Kerry Marsh. And I just wanted to kind of share with you the idea that when we do single mic, it's very exposed. So it takes a lot of work on their part to be ready for that. They've done an excellent job with it. And I'm really proud of what they've been able to accomplish. And I hope you enjoy these two quick numbers, these jazz tunes. Generally you do, you know, three or four fast tunes and a couple of ballads. But we ended up with just a couple of ballads in this one because this is something that we also did with our community choir, and so they learned a little bit for that as well. But these two tunes here, they're jazz tunes and ballads arranged by Kerry Marsh, Great Bend native, graduated from Great Bend High School, and now in Lawrence.